Good morning, class. Today we'll start with the comparison between three states of matter. That is the topic which is remaining. Here we have to learn about the properties which are going to be the differential between solid, liquid, and gas. Very first property we will talk about, that is arrangement of particles. How the particles are arranged. Okay. So arrangement of particles when we talked about. So you can see that particles of solids, they are tightly packed. You can see here there is no space in between them. The particles are tightly packed. You can see in the diagram that particles are tightly packed. So you can write that they are tightly packed. Particles of liquid are loosely packed. They have space in between them. They are loosely packed. You can write that. And we will talk about gas. The particles are free to move. Okay, they are free to move. From this we have to learn about two of the particular more property. One is space, interparticle space and interparticle force. And third is interparticle force of attraction. So from this diagram only we can just have idea about the space, that they do not have space. Particles do not have space. They have space and they are having, they have more space than that of solid and liquid. Children, that is about the comparison between solid, liquid and gas for particles. The space between the particles and what is the force of attraction between the particles. So here they do not have space, we can say that they have strongest force of attraction. Here we can say that they have moderate force of attraction. And they have very less or negligible force of attraction, because particles having a larger space when compared to solid and liquid. Now children, we'll learn about the new particular property about it, that is about shape and size and volume. Then we just have to learn about the one of the particular, that is the rigid of fluid. Now fourth property is, what do you say about their shape and volume? So when we talked about solid, we can say that they have fixed shape and volume. Fixed volume. Here we can say that they have fixed volume, but they gain the no fixed volume or no fixed shape, because when we talked about water, if we fill the water in the test tube, it is just having a shape like a test tube. If we fill in the particular beaker, then it will just gain the shape like beaker. Okay, so it just gain the shape like the container in which they are filled, and they gases, they do not have no fixed shape and volume, we can say that. Okay. So that is all about the shape and volume. Now we learn about the next particular property. It is, are they rigid or fluid? Rigidity and fluidity. Now rigidity, that means when they apply pressure on that particular object, they are not going to be there bend out. So we can say that solid are rigid. They show rigidity. Okay, they show rigidity. And here, liquid, they do not show rigidity. They show fluidity. They show highest fluidity. So gases are highest fluidity. The definition of fluidity. Fluidity is the tendency to flow. The particular object has tendency to flow. अगर पानी गीला है तो it's just having a slope, it's just having a tendency to flow from the upper direction to the lower direction. वो ऊपर से नीचे अपने आप flow करेगा. Gases, you can see the air in the surrounding, it is flow by itself. So we can say that gases are highly fluid compared to solid and liquid. Now we learn about the new property. That what we have already learned, and that is diffusion. What do you say about the diffusion property for solid, liquid, and diffusion? We know that we It is the intermixing of the particles of one substance to another substance by its own. So we can say that solid do not show diffusion. Here, liquid shows diffusion. Here, it also shows diffusion. But when we compare the diffusion properties for solid, liquid, and gas, gas shows highest diffusion than that of liquid, and liquid shows highest than that of solid. So most of the gases, they are highly diffused one. They can intermix by intermix with the particles by their own. एक पार्टिकल्स जो भी सब्सटेंस का है द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ वन सब्सटेंस दे कैन इंटरमिक्स विद द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ अनदर सब्सटेंस बाय देयर ओन विच इज अबाउट द सॉलिड लिक्विड एंड गैस. नाउ वी टू लर्न अबाउट द न्यू प्रॉपर्टी दैट इज कंप्रेसिबिलिटी. सी कंप्रेसिबिलिटी इज अ प्रॉपर्टी इन विच व्हेनेवर फोर्स इज अप्लाइड देयर इज अ चेंज इन द पोजीशन एंड द शेप ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट सॉलिड्स दे आर हाईली इनकंप्रेसिबल. वी कैन से दैट दे आर हाईली इनकंप्रेसिबल. Except sponge. Sponge is compressible. Okay. Why? Because suppose this is sponge, it is having tiny pores inside in it, and which trap the air inside in it. So when we apply pressure, that air comes out and it is able to compress. So except sponge, all the solids are highly compressible. We can say that liquid are moderately compressible, and gases are highly compressible. For this, one of the activities is given in your textbook by the use of syringe. Suppose this is a piston, lower part is piston and that is a syringe. If it is there, fit with the rubber cork, and if you just apply the chalk powder, if you are filling the chalk powder inside it, and when we apply pressure to it, there is no change in the level of the piston, which says us that particular solids are incompressible. यहाँ पे अगर चॉक पाउडर है तो देयर इज नो चेंज इन द लेवल ऑफ द पिस्टन्स. इंस्टेड ऑफ चॉक इफ आई एम अप्लाइंग वाटर इन इट, चॉक पाउडर की जगह पर अगर मेरे पास वाटर है, सो दैट लेवल ऑफ द पिस्टन इज समवॉट चेंज. सो वी कैन से दैट लिक्विड आर मॉडरेटली कंप्रेसिबल. इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर इफ गैस इज देयर then it is highly compressible. That activity is there given in your textbook. So that is about the compressibility. 8.1 we have to learn about kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is energy required to motion of the particles. Particles of solids, they do not have space, so we can say that they have negligible kinetic energy. They have moderate kinetic energy and they have highest kinetic energy. So that is all about the comparison between the three states of matter. Now second part which we have to learn about, that is interconversion of state of matter. Now interconversion, that means we can change the states of matter from one state to another state. And when we talked about interconversion, the part 2 le rahe hain, so that is about interconversion of state of matter. Three states of matter. It is done by two ways, by changing temperature and changing pressure. We learn about temperature. If we are changing the temperature, how it will interconvert? Suppose that is solid. If I am changing the temperature, if I am increasing the temperature, it will convert into liquid. And if I am changing the temperature, if I am just increasing the temperature, that will be converted into gas. Now if I am just decreasing the temperature, liquid convert into solid, and if I am just gases convert into liquid. Solid directly converted into gas as well as solid directly converted into gas directly converted into gas. So when we talk about solid directly converted into this liquid, the process is known as melting. Yahan pe main likh raha hu interconversion from solid to liquid, that particular process is known as melting or fusion. We'll just talk one after another. If liquid, when we increase the temperature to liquid and convert into gas, that process is known as boiling evaporation or vaporization. So that's what we have to learn today, briefly learn about that what is melting, what is fusion. So this is known as melting. Here you can write boiling or evaporation. Here it is freezing or solidification. That's what we learn afterwards, children. यहाँ पे सबसे पहले हम देखते हैं how we are studying learn about what is melting, what is fusion. So if I am changing the process of यहाँ पे अगर melting है तो melting is also known as fusion. You can say that and the process of conversion of solid state into liquid by heating, or you can write by changing the temperature. So that process is known as melting or fusion. Now we have to learn about the very new term, that is melting point. इसके अंदर ही हमें दूसरा पढ़ना है about melting point. So here it is known as the point of temperature. यहाँ पे दो टर्म सीखनी है, मेल्टिंग फ्यूजन, बोथ आर द सेम टर्म. जहाँ पे देयर इज इंटर कन्वर्जन ऑफ स्टेट ऑफ सॉलिड इनटू लिक्विड बाय हीटिंग, और यू कैन राइट इट बाय चेंजिंग द टेम्परेचर. और द पॉइंट ऑफ टेम्परेचर, जो टेम्परेचर पे सॉलिड मेल्ट होना स्टार्ट होता है और कन्वर्ट हो जाता है लिक्विड में, दैट पर्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर इज नोन एज मेल्टिंग पॉइंट. ठीक है, उसे मेल्टिंग पॉइंट बोला जाएगा. नाउ वी हैव टू लर्न अबाउट दैट विच एनर्जी कन्वर्ट दैट सॉलिड इनटू लिक्विड. सी, अगर हम खाते हैं, if we are taking a food, it will going to be get digested. We cannot see that digestion process. Even we cannot see that energy which is just giving energy to do the work. हम वो energy देख नहीं सकते जो हमें काम करने के लिए प्रोत्साहित करती है. ठीक है, उसी तरह जब भी solid liquid में convert होता है, so that energy remain hidden. और इसीलिए हमें नई जो पढ़नी है, latent heat of fusion. So latent is a Greek word. ये ग्रीक वर्ड है, दैट इज बीट एज हीडन. सो यहाँ पे मैं डेफिनेशन लिखूंगी, द हीडन एनर्जी रिक्वायर्ड टू कन्वर्ट 1 kilogram ऑफ सॉलिड इनटू लिक्विड एट इट्स मेल्टिंग पॉइंट. जब भी सॉलिड लिक्विड में कन्वर्ट हो तो वी हैव टू राइट मेल्टिंग पॉइंट इज नोन एज लेटेंट हीट ऑफ फ्यूजन. ठीक है, सो दैट व्हाट वी हैव लर्न. नाउ वी लर्न अबाउट द बॉइलिंग प्रोसेस. द नेक्स्ट प्रोसेस इज बॉइलिंग. बॉइलिंग इज ऑल्सो नोन एज इवेपोरेशन और वेपराइजेशन. यहाँ पे हम लिखेंगे द प्रोसेस इन विच बॉइलिंग, दूसरी प्रोसेस में इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज इवेपोरेशन और वेपराइजेशन. नाउ दिस इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द प्रोसेस इन विच लिक्विड कन्वर्ट्स इनटू गैस बाय हीटिंग. Now we have to learn about the new term boiling point. So the point of temperature, we can write that the point of temperature at which liquid starts to boil, liquid boil hona start hoga not even guess. And its atmospheric pressure, तो उसे बोला जाएगा boiling point. ठीक है, अभी फिर से आप एक नई नाम पढ़नी है, that is latent heat of evaporation or vaporization. So the hidden energy, same word we are writing, the hidden energy required to convert 1 kilogram of liquid into gas at its boiling point. उसके boiling point पे जब भी 1 kilogram of liquid convert होता है gas में, that is known as latent heat of evaporation. समझ आ रहा है यहाँ तक? So that is all about today. In our next class, we are starting with the remaining one, that is freezing or solidification, condensation and sublimation. Till that much of time, please see the video carefully and learn whatever we are going to explain in the class. Thank you and have a nice day.